Tony Cairoli has got it. Yeah.
Man, the first pole shot from our 19th champion.
That was nice. We needed that one. That was real nice.
Get a few tips.
Yeah, I got some tips from the master. Tape on my hands because they are hurting.
You got a new mechanic, mate?
Yeah, new mechanic. I hope he does mechanic, not rider.
With Tony, we just softened things up a little bit. I think on the weekend when he raced here, he was a hair overdamped for the racetrack. So we try to come back on that. And for Aaron, we just wanted to get a little bit more stability out of the bike.
Rake the front end out.
Yeah.
Like let everything move. The last few changes were like
better.
The tracks develop in a very different way. The American riders tend to make everything really sharp. So a lot of the corners have these huge hooks in them. And the European riders don't ride like that. They keep a nice flow through there. The same can be said for the American riders when they head over to Europe. They also struggle a little bit because they're looking for all these insides and there are none.
How is it?
Some gift from race one. If you want to be here and win, and for the championship, you need to prepare also, like all other championships, you need to be prepared. And I really enjoy to be here because I always want to race the Pro Motocross races. We are not on the level we should be, but I just want to feel a little bit better each race. Don't make mistakes and just enjoy the trip. That's more or less what's the plan.
When you hit like the harsh bumps, like after the finish line?
Boom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like very abrupt.
Yeah.
I think my shot was better than your shot, not gonna lie.
Make sure you get the bullet, bro.
I broke my collarbone at Hangtown because it was a four lap sprint on like this. And we're just going wide open. Stupid.
Go, Jay!
Hi!
Obviously, Tony and I have been pretty close for, ever since I started racing GPs over there, and then we haven't raced each other much at all. It felt good to kind of reminisce about times back then, It's crazy, like, I'm not old by any means, but it feels like it is so long ago since I've been over there. It's been over 10 years. That's nuts.
How's the track?
It's a little rough. Long rush.
Long rush. Not big bumps, I think, huh?
Bumpy, not so much, but a little rough. Long rush with a little bumps inside.
Okay, good.
He's always gear higher, like most Europeans ride like him.
But he's extremely good at it. Yes. The thing is, he can also do it in races, and most guys can ride like that in practice. And then in the races, they forget that they shift. They hate when you elevate. The second of losses, I'm heading them out, yeah, I had to go delegate.
I feel like I'm floating, I'm lost in the moment, that's why I could levitate. Wait, all right, Panda Express?
I like Panda Express better than
Chipotle. Better than Chipotle?
Yeah.
What?
I'm more for Latino music, not for Latino music, than I'm more for Chinese.
It's bad for you.
Yeah? Panda Express is bad?
Yes.
What?
Fried.
No, it's not so fried.
Two time! Number 7, baby, right there. KTM truck, doing it.
thanks that we get a race right here at this beautiful venue, Hangtown 2022. Oh yeah.
Tony, dude, we love you over here, baby.
Thank you.
Can't wait to see you.
Yeah, pretty busy because they never had the chance to see me, so it's nice to spend some time. Yeah, good luck.
We weren't expecting Antonio Cairoli, and let alone Ryan Dungey, to have that many championships join at the last minute is just fantastic. I'm a huge fan of Antonio's. He doesn't have anything to prove, but the fact that he's up for this challenge, that's the kind of champion he is.
The fact that Tony came out of retirement and, you know, get to race against him, and, you know, we've raced each other at the designations. We've spent time in Rome with him and his wife. They've taken us to dinner, and they're super amazing people. And so to be able to be here in America and similar positions coming out of retirement, it's pretty cool. And yeah, it's a breath of fresh air just to have him under the tent too and hang out and see his kid, little Chase, run around and see Jill and just a lot of respect for him and his whole family. So yeah, it's a pretty sweet situation to be in.
What?
How's the
leg? Leg is okay now.
Yeah, he told me when he was little till now, he's maybe trained on 6 different tracks. So I think we've taken him to 6 different tracks in 1 week here in California. So another good test ahead of him. All these guys have raced here multiple times. They all kind of know what's going on.
From what I watch on TV, always was very hard pack. It looks like they work very good on the track. They bring maybe some other kind of ground, and it's quite soft, a lot of lines. Some section a little bit too slow, I think, from what I see for now, but maybe they will modify something.
We'll see.
Some supercross section. I didn't get such a good reaction out of the gate, and after that I was riding 12. They passed me at first lap, I think 2 or 3 riders. I was a little bit not ready for the rhythm. I settled a little bit late with the rhythm of the race, and then I tried to gain some momentum again, and I arrived until Ryan on the last lap. So I need to get a better start, because you know, without training it's even harder, you know, to come through the pack, and you risk a lot because you're not fit. So if you have a good, let's say top 5 start, it will be much easier, and maybe we can stay there, you know, easier. Instead of coming from the back without training, it's quite tough. Because in the front, always like...
Yeah, all you have to go with the good guys.
Good guys to the format, and takes a few races, let's say. So I say, okay, I'm here anyway, and then we have 15 days break, and maybe I go back to home a little bit, and after we see. But you know, just because we were already here, and then I say, okay, we stay for 2 more races, and we have some more experience.
Awesome start, and then he was up there, and from what I heard, I haven't spoken to him directly, but I heard he was hanging up there a little bit, but the pace was a little more than what he thought, and he kind of pumped up a little bit. But overall, it was good to see him up there with those guys mixing it up, and it was a great start. And he seems to be catching fire here a little bit now.
Very good jump off the gate. We missed a little bit of sprint in the first 3-4 laps. After I settled, let's say, on a good pace, but the first 3-4 laps were a little bit too slow. So we lost a lot of time on the first 3-4 laps, and after it was okay riding, but you know, to come to the guys, because also my condition is not so good and I cannot push how I want in the end. But anyway, a little improvement from last week, so I'm quite happy.
Chase, sorridi.